Good morning, students of class 9D. We are doing chapter The Snake and the Mirror. We have already read this chapter. We have completed the reading. And today we would be doing question answers and back exercises. But before that, again, a quick revision of the chapter for those who were not there in between the days, fine. And I would be showing you one video also, the complete chapter in few minutes only, fine. Now, the characters of the chapter, firstly, the author, then we have homeopathic doctor, who is the protagonist. Protagonist means the main character of the story. Then we have snake. Snake is also one of the characters in the story. And mirror, though it is a non-living object, but even then we can consider mirror as one of the characters in the story. Okay, so this is a narrative within a narrative, story within a story. We are reading The Snake and the Mirror, but actually how it started, author of this chapter and along with his friends, they are sitting together and they are discussing their narratives, their personal experiences. And then homeopathic doctor was sitting in that group and he says, have you ever experienced being chased by a snake? And this homeopathic doctor starts narrating his story to author and others. So that's why it is called story within a story. Clear? Then snake and mirror, they are part of this chapter. Those who are joining late, beta, tomorrow onwards, I won't allow. After 10 minutes, you people join. See. So then theme, main theme of this chapter is human vanity, human fears. Now, what is human vanity? I have already discussed with you all. Let me revise again. That when we people are, you know, we're spending our time in the things which even, you know, are not meant for us. We people run after physical beauty. Fine. We people run after looking good, but nobody works upon being good inside out. Clear? So, human fears. We are very scared of wild animals. We are very scared of such poisonous animals and creatures like snake. Otherwise, we never show our fears unless and until we are faced with it. Clear? So, in this story, a young doctor who has just started his career as a homeopathic doctor, who's very poor, who cannot afford rich and very good life. And he's just boasting about his personality. He's just saying that he's being boasting about a doctor. He's boasting about his profession. So one should not, you know, be overconfident in life. Though he's having very meager, you can say, things in his life only. He's just living in a rented room with no electricity, with 60 rupees in his bag and rats everywhere and holes are there. And only one lamp, a mirror and a table and a comb is there. And he's just having few clothes and one black coat only, which he was wearing. Fine. Even then he was just self-obsessed about how he looks, how he should shave himself, how should he grow a thin mustache and how he should put on attractive smile. Then he thinks about his marriage, that how he would get married to a rich doctor who will be good, you can say having good experience, and she should be fat because whenever they will be arguing on one or the other thing, she won't be able to run after him. So this story is humorous also, many incidents which are quite funny. The next theme is crisis make people remember God. Otherwise we never remember God, but when we are in the, you can say, bad days of our life or in the, you can say, crisis is there, some then we start, you know, remembering God. So this is one of the themes, and arrogance of human being that comes under human vanity only. Clear? That we start being arrogant about material objects and our looks and physical beauty, fine, rather than improving our from within, you can say, we just keep on thinking about our outer beauty. So this is the theme. Clear? Send me thumbs up if theme and all the characters are clear to you. Story we have already read. You must know. And the justification of title, The Snake and the Mirror. Why? Because in the mirror, beta, what does a mirror do? Mirror just reflects our reality to us. Whatever we see, whatever is real is being reflected by the mirror. Fine, when that homeopathic doctor sees his image, it was telling the truth. When a snake also looks into the mirror, actually the mirror was there with doctor every time, and mirror also saved his life. Firstly, he was thinking about his own beauty, his own, you can say, how handsome he is. And then this mirror only saved his life. When the snake started looking into the mirror, he got allured towards it. Maybe it got attracted towards its own beauty and he wanted to have a closer look. And then it went nearby the mirror, and then the life of this doctor was saved. So the mirror has also played very important role. That's why I have written this mirror as one of the non-living characters. Fine. Now I would be sharing screen and would be showing one video to you all.
Adrenaline can help you run quickly and rapidly, so you never have to slow down. Stay on top of him. The snake in the mirror. I like on the mirror machine.
So, you can see the name of author is written here. Fine. Otherwise, we people never pay attention to. We just remember, okay, this poem is written by this poet and all, but we never, you know, put efforts to just learn the name of authors of chapters. Though they are not mentioned, you're not asked even in the exams, but one should know. This is V.M. Bashir. Y.com Muhammad Bashir has written this chapter. Okay?
Muhammad Bashir. It is the story of a doctor who has just started his medical practice. He owns a meager income and lives in a small rented room, which is an outhouse with a tiled roof. The beam on which the gable is supported is full of rats.
So you can see the condition of the room in this animated video. Fine, I would be showing and I would be speaking in this. Yes, so you can see the gable is supported, is full of rats. Rats keep on moving. One summer night, he went to a restaurant, a small restaurant, and after having his meal, he came back to his rented room, which is very in a very pathetic condition. And he hears voices from the above, but he does not pay attention. What he does, he takes off his coat and then he starts reading one of the books. Medical based book, because he was just a new doctor now. And you can see now, yes, I would be stopping here. You can see the objects lying in this. Only a few objects he was having. You have seen the condition of the room. There is no electricity, only a book, a mirror, a lamp, and a comb is lying on the table. Fine. So he is having very few, you can say, things in his room. That shows he was a very poor doctor. Fine. And he starts to read because he was not able to sleep. Let's continue. When he was reading, suddenly his eyes fell upon in the mirror. And what he does, he starts looking at his image. And he starts, you know, this is called, I told you in the beginning, you remember that when you see mirror, what do you think about yourself? Then you people were saying, ma'am, we just look, we talk to ourselves. Sometimes we don't talk to ourselves. Sometimes you comb over here when you're going out for party. So this is the human, you can say, nature. Whenever we see mirror, we start looking at ourselves. We start thinking about our beauty or our handsomeness. So this doctor, he's self-obsessed. He starts looking at himself. That how handsome he looks, that he's not married and he's a doctor too. He should look more handsome. Fine. This is what he's thinking. He wanted to find a better match for himself. Fine. The way he's looking at himself, he can very well. And he decides to shave daily. See, very important. This is a question. What the decision he made after looking into the mirror, that he would be shaving daily. He would be growing a thin mustache. And moreover, he would be keeping an attractive smile on his face. See, so that he would get better match. And then gradually his thoughts shift from self-admiration to getting married to a fat woman, a rich woman, a doctor woman who's having good experience. Why fat? Because this is humorous, that when she would, they will be having any arguments and she won't be able to run and catch him. So again, he's just, you can say, lost in daydreaming. He's so engrossed that he does not even pay attention that there is sudden silence. Even rats stopped producing noise now. And he was so busy in self-admiration. Now see, he's so lost that he even did not pay attention that there is no, you can say, noise of the rats now. Clear? And a snake is going to wriggle over at the back of the chair and going to land on it, his shoulder. And he realizes when already he has caught or wriggled one of his arms, that is left arm. Okay, you should know which arm it is. It is left arm. And only 3-4 inches away, he is going to spread his hood. And he thinks of various medicines. Now doctor's mind is working. He's thinking that if it stings me, what sort of medicine I would be having. He was so scared. He's not moving. He has turned like a statue only. And he's thinking that God has punished him. And suddenly snake sees its own image in the mirror. And maybe it got attracted towards the mirror. Now it would be leaving the arms. And he was so, you know, slowly and steadily it left arm of the doctor. And it started looking himself in the mirror. This was the time when doctor got a chance to sneak away and to run away. And he runs away like anything, that runs away straight away to his friend's house. And next morning he comes back with two of his friends because he was scared that snake might be there just for help's sake. But unfortunately, what happened? Nothing was left behind. His table, his chair, his mirror and comb and books and clothing and 60 rupees he was having and lamp he was having. Nothing was there. Empty room was there. And only vest, a dirty vest was left. And then doctor says he should have taken this dirty vest. This is the dirty vest lying over there. And he thought ki ye bhi le jata. He should have taken this and he should have used it. And maybe he was cleanliness freak. That's why he left this behind. This vest was of no use to doctor now. Okay. So this was beta the story. Now, I would be showing you the question answers. I would be sharing with you all. And let's start. Now, I won't be telling the answers. I have just given the detailed account of the story. You people will actively participate. Switch on the videos. These are the questions, beta, which we are going to discuss. Discuss in pairs and answer each question below in a short paragraph, 30-40 words. So, remember the word limit. These are the very short questions, only 2 to 3 lines or 3 to 4 lines, not more than that. Okay. First question is, the sound was a familiar one. What sound did the doctor hear? What did he think it was? How many times did he hear it? Now, kindly see, there are 3 questions in this. The sound was a familiar one. This is a statement. What sound did the doctor hear? What did he think it was and how many times did he hear? There are 3 parts to this question. Yes, Tatiksha. Speak clearly and loudly.
Yes, ma'am. The doctor heard the sound of rats. The sound was familiar one. He heard this sound for 4 times. The phrases are again, I heard the sound from above. Again, came the noise from above. Suddenly, there come a dull thud, as if a rubber tube has fallen. The sound stopped after the appearance of the snake.
Yes, fine. So, exact answer. Well done, Pratiksha. She has given The sound was a familiar one. So actually, the what sound did the doctor hear? The sound, you can hear yourself. The sound belonged to rats, fine. So rats were producing those sounds, fine. And obviously, what did the doctor think it was? And it came for four times, beta. The teacher has mentioned the times also and given the statement. So approximately it was four times. Fine. He knew that there are rats in his room. And when and why did the sound stop? After the falling of the snake, when the third sound was heard, as if a rubber tube had fallen. And after that snake's appearance, and why did it happen? Anybody knows? You know, snakes can eat completely the rats. So rats are scared of snake. That's why maybe they disappeared. So they have not mentioned this reason, but you should know. Okay. So Lisa has raised hand. Lisa, you would be giving answer to second question. What is the second question? What two important and earth-shaking decisions did the doctor make while he was looking into the mirror? Earth-shaking. This is a funny way of asking. They were not for earth shaking. Yes. Lisa, you can answer better. Speak clearly and loudly.
Okay, ma'am. One, he would shave daily. Second, he would grow a thin moustache to look more handsome. Third, he would always keep that attractive smile on his face.
Very good. Fine. So you can mute yourself. So Lisa Batra has given all the complete answers. They have asked for two important decisions, but there are actually three decisions he has made. Firstly, he would shave daily. You will tell that homeopathic doctor wanted to look handsome always. So he decided that he would be doing his shave on daily basis. He would be growing a thin mustache to look more handsome. Moreover, he would be keeping an attractive smile all the time on his face. Okay, now third question is, I looked into the mirror and smiled, says the doctor. A little later he says, I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. There are the two statements, beta. What is the doctor's opinion about himself when he first smiles and secondly he smiles again? In what way do his thoughts change in between? And my question starts from here. What is the doctor's opinion about himself? So Divya, you can speak loudly, beta.
Yes, ma'am. When the doctor first saw his smile, he thinks that his smile is attractive and he looks handsome. When he smiles again, he smiles out of nervousness. He was nervous and feared because his life was in danger.
Yes, very good. So exactly what I was expecting the answer. There is difference between two smiles. Firstly, he smiles when he was self-obsessed, when he was praising his smile and he was thinking that he has a very attractive smile. And secondly, when snake has wriggled around his left arm and he smiled in the helpless manner, he smiled out of nervousness. Fine, he smiled because his life was in danger and he could not do anything about it. So actually he was helpless and nervous, so he could not help but smiling. Fine. Next is the story about a frightening incident is narrated in a humorous way. What makes it humorous? Humorous means funny. Think of the contrasts. Beta, contrasts mean difference. Fine. Dream and reality. So the kind of person the doctor is, the kind of person he wants to be. So you have to tell the difference between these two things, that what is the reality in the first part, and you have to tell about his money and possessions, and second one is daydreaming, the kind of person he wants to become. Yes. Only what about other students? The same students are raising hands. I want some new students, beta. Boys also, you should take part. What happens to you? You send very beautifully, the homework is done, but when it comes to speaking, only girls are raising hand. Equal participation should be there. So should I name you? Firstly, switch on the videos. Yes, Bhavansh, would you like to answer this? The reality and daydreaming one. Where are other boys? no response from boys at all. And now he is also, you know, gone behind. I would like to ask Prachi, can you speak, beta? Arisham, anyone? Same girls are raising hand. I want beta other students to speak also. Pratiksha, yes, definitely. I would be asking from these students only, but I am just waiting the others should also speak. Where are rest of the students? Jia, what is the reality, beta? One part you can give answer if you don't know the both parts. Jia Mago. Pushti. Okay, this question goes to Titiksha. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. First, the doctor is a poor man. He does not have much money. His house has no electricity. It has a small rented room which has many rats. He has about 60 rupees in his suitcase along with some shirts and dhotis. He also possesses a solitary black coat. Second answer, he wants to be a handsome person, so he decides to shave daily and grow a thin mustache. He also wishes to accumulate wealth.
Very good. So all the points covered well. I need not even repeat. Fine. Then next question is, the kind of a person he wants to be. Anybody would like to speak on this again? Lisa?
Yes, ma'am. First part, the doctor wants to be rich. The doctor wants to marry a woman doctor. He wants that she should have a good medical practice and a lot of money. She should be fat as not to run after him and catch him. Second Fine. Answer, he marries a thin, reedy woman. She has the gift of a sprinter.
Fine. So this is clear to everyone. The person he wants to marry and the person he actually marries. He wants to marry a rich practicing doctor who is fat, fine, and who has good experience, who is rich also. But actually he gets married to a very thin, reedy person. Fine, very thin, tall and thin, jisko kehte hain, R-E-E-D-Y. This is the textual language only. And who has gift of sprinter. So actual reality was quite different from. Then third question is, his thoughts when he looks into the mirror, his thoughts when the snake is coiled around his arm. Yes, Divya.
Yes, ma'am. When he looks into the mirror, he thinks that he should have a thin mustache and should keep his attractive smile on his face to look more handsome. When the snake coiled his arms, he was nervous and acknowledged the presence of God and starts to pray the God to save him.
Well done. Fine. So it's clear to all of you. Any doubt? Now the next one is, beta, I would be rather than discussing the, you can say this exercise, this is your homework. Fine. You would be doing page number 61, kindly note down, because this is just, you have to tell that which statement was spoken at what point of time, when he was afraid or when he was proud of his appearance or when he had a sense of humor. You have to bifurcate the statements only 1 to 10. You just write, suppose I give you first answer. I was turned to stone. This statement shows that doctor was afraid. Fine. Yes, Tadiksha, if you have done, very good. I'm not going to ask the same students again and again. So tomorrow you just complete all the exercises that you will be doing in your book only, not in the notebook. In the notebook, you would be writing this 30 to 40 words one and the second one, which we have discussed recently. Fine. All the questions which we have discussed recently that you will be writing in your fear notebook. Fine. And I would be telling you when to send the PDF. Okay. When one writing skill will be done, then you will be sending me, not now. thinking about the language, expressions used to show fear, then page number 61 and page number 62. We are having exercises which will be done by you only. Okay, this is your homework. And then on page number 63, beta, there is one dictation paragraph. In this, you will be just using punctuation marks. You should know where to put the comma, where to put, you can say, capital letter, where to put full stop and inverted commas and all. That you will do on the book itself again. Then we have writing part. This we will be doing in our notebook. We are not having much time today. So I would be discussing tomorrow. Clear? We will be doing our writing skill fine tomorrow and page number 63 of this book only tomorrow. Exercises you will do on your own. Okay, if any doubt will be there, I would be putting it in the, you can ask me in the notebooks group also. Okay, bell has gone. Have a nice day and complete your task side by side. Only 3-4 students are left who have not sent me any assignment, beta. Your assessment marks will be affected then. Send me today by all means by 2 p.m. After that, I won't accept. Tomorrow, I won't be checking because I have to choose best assignments also. Okay? Have a nice day, beta.